might have on the morale of the American teenager. No, I'm not suggesting the boy doesn't want to go into the army, it's just that... No, I wasn't trying to. It just seemed to me that 2 weeks from today, at the induction center, he'll be there. Oh, Rosie, thank God you've come. This is the end of Alabama Music Corporation. Conrad Birdie is going into the army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation.
Huh?
I just dropped in to say goodbye, Oliver, darling. Lots of luck.
Rosie, you can't. Not today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? The little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Not so much. Break it in half.
Albert, you're 33 years old. You can take a whole aspirin.
I'm not 33. I'm a long way from 33. I won't be 33 until... tomorrow. Water.
Albert, it's no use. My mind's made up. I've been with Alma Lou for 8 years now, and as you all know, I've been more than just a secretary to you.
Rose, those are moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness in the office, I put in a good 90-hour week. And for what? A $5 raise in 1954 and a bottle of our page last Christmas?
Well, you know how the saying goes, Rosie. Promise her anything. Give her a page.
But not 16th of an ounce! And besides, I want something more.
If you're referring to anything of a more permanent nature between us, I'm not ready for it. And besides, there are religious differences.
Being from Pennsylvania is not a religious difference.
And if it's a part of the company you're after, the answer is no to that, too. Alma Lou is me, Mama, and Lou. Any changes to that would kill the woman who bore me.
Nothing could kill your mother, Albert, except maybe a silver bullet.
And I'm not dropping poor old Lou either. He loved you, Rose.
I love Lou, too. Sure, he was warm, he was loyal, he was lovable. But he died 6 years ago. And besides, he was a wired-haired terrier. Anyhow, it's not a part of the company I want. This is something much more important.
If you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss, Albert. Conrad Birdie's going into the army, and I've quit. There's nothing left for you to do, except go back to college and get your...
Rosie, I'm up to ears in debt. Conrad Birdie's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. And I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this could be your last chance. Albert, are you listening to me?
He's going in the army is the best thing he can do. Now you're free to start to do what you wanted to. Albert, Albert, Albert. I remember how you told me I should trust you for a year. It would just be for a year.
Build a business.
It was only a sideline, that's what she said. You just needed some money, that's what she said. You were going to college and get ahead. Instead of being a music business bum, you were going to NYU and become...
Don't say it, Rosie.
An English teacher.
Rose.
And furthermore, he wrote poetry.
Rose, please.
It is an NYU yearbook of 1952 under Al Peterson's favorite piece of literature.
You get a summer vacation, and we window will like me.
Rosie, I'll make a deal with you. Stay with me. Help me pay off Conrad's guarantee, and I promise you, as soon as I'm out of the red, I'll dissolve the company and go back into the academic life.
Albert, you're on.
But of course, this may take a few years. Say, well, it's 1973 or 74 at the latest. What is that?
Something that'll move that date up a few years. Pick a name.
Pick what name? What are you talking about?
Fine, I'll do it. McAfee. Kim McAfee. Age 15, president and secretary, Conrad Birdie fan club member 2408 of Sweet Apple, Ohio. Hi, Mary. Could you get me the Sweet Apple, Ohio? The number is 7-8-8-2-0, and call me right back.
Now, wait a minute. What's going on? Who is Kim, whatever her name is?
Kim McAfee, Albert, is going to send you back to college with the biggest hit this company has ever seen, and it's called One Last Kiss.
Well, I've never heard of it.
Well, you haven't read it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie going into the army for 2 cold years, and when he gives that kiss to one of his fans chosen at random from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, it'll make him the biggest soldier since Joan of Arc.
Rose, I'm beginning to see it. We caught the record here in New York.
Take that greasy bongo-playing car thief to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Oh, Albert, you'll make enough money to stay in college for the rest of your life.
Oh, Rose, it's wonderful. And I promise you, as soon as this thing is settled, it'll just be the two of us. You, me, and perfect bliss. And I'll become an English teacher and... bliss. Kiss. That rhymes. I wonder if anyone's used it before. Ah, what difference does it make? It'll be great for this all. Oh, one last kiss. It gives me so much bliss. What's your dentifrice? No, that's too clinical.
Kim McAfee just got pinned to who? Never mind, Mary. Keep trying and call me right back. Then we will have such a wonderful life.
Saturday? because Hugo Peabody gave you his pin doesn't mean you have to retire from all social life. There are some things, like going study, that are very important. And there are some things that are more important than very important. And the Conrad Birdie Fan Club is one of them. I mean, where else can we girls go together to worship that wonderful creature? Do you realize what you'd be giving up, Kim?
I'm sorry, Ursula, but my mind's made up. Of course I'll still listen to his records, but things like the Conrad Birdie Pledge and the Scream are behind me now.
You mean, whenever you hear Conrad, you're not just gonna go, ah!
Oh, Kim.
Kim, dear, would you please get off the phone? I've got some calls to make.
Yes, Mother. I'm sorry, Ursula, but I've got to call you back. You'll tell the other kids, won't you?
I mean, I suppose I'll have to, but Kim, are you sure? I mean, really? Are you positive? Are you absolutely certain?
Positive. I'm 15. It's time I start to settle down. When your skinny child of 14, wired with braces from ear to ear, you doubt that you could ever be a feeling. Then, hallelujah, you are 15, the braces disappear, and your skin is smooth and clear, and you have that happy grown-up female feeling. Cigarette? I seem to have run out.
I'm not an old man. I was 18 in World War II.
Conrad, Birdie is coming here to see me? Doris? Mother? Oh, Mommy!
Baby, what is it? What's wrong?
It's Conrad, Birdie. He's coming here to kiss me.
Oh, that's nice. Now you just put your head on Mommy's shoulder.
No, you don't understand. Conrad, Birdie is coming to Sweet Avenue, Ohio to give me a kiss goodbye. Oh, Mommy!
I never thought I'd say it, but God bless Conrad, Birdie.
Now let's run the Conrad Birdie song one more time before we head down to the station. And remember the Conrad Birdie creed, dear. No smoking until you're 14. All right, now shall we try it?
We love you, Conrad. Oh yes, we do. We love you, Conrad.
Oh, little girl, you can sing with us if you want. What's the matter with her?
Oh, she's just sad because Conrad's going into the army and she'll be too old for him when he gets out.
She still has a good few years left. Here, why don't you go sit down to the station and I'll talk to her. And stay out of the bar! Hi, I'm Albert Peterson, Conrad's manager. Oh, come on, now things can't be that black. Just smile. Little girl, an adult is speaking. I order you to smile. Please. Gray skies are gonna clear up. Put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up. Put on a happy face. Take off the glooming mask of tragedy. It's not your style. You'll look so good that you'll be glad you decided to smile. Pick out a pleasant outlook. Stick out that noble chin. Wipe off that full of down look. Slap on a happy grin. And spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Think of banana splits and licorice, and you'll feel fine. I knew a girl so gloomy, she wouldn't laugh or sing. She wouldn't listen to me, now she's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place, just put on a happy face. My gosh, there's our luggage. Hurry now, that I'm going to head down the track trail before Conrad goes. Come on now. Oh boy, would you bring down the track trail on the double? Rosie, what are you doing?
Just getting our stuff down to the station with no help from you, Albert.
Oh, Rosie, I'm sorry. I don't suppose a generous stimp can help.
Just take your briefcase and head down to the station. You don't want Conrad to talk to those reporters alone. You know what happened last time.
You hang on to it. I've got to wait for Mama.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, have you told her about dissolving the company yet?
I couldn't, Rosie. Yesterday was the anniversary.
Of what?
Lowell. 6 years ago, he was hit on 181st Street in Broadway by a loaded beer truck.
Yoo-hoo!
Do you suppose that's Mama?
It's either her or the all clear.
Yoo-hoo! Sunny!
Oh, Mama, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing. I'm just a little faint from the subway.
Mama, I told you to take a taxi.
Taxi? What do I need with taxis? I'll leave the taxis for my successful son. A mother can ride crowded in a dirty subway full of foreign people who wouldn't give you a seat if their life depended on it. But what's the difference? Nowadays, a mother is lower than dirt anyways. Here's the money I saved from not taking the taxi. Buy some candy with it. Who's she?
Oh, Mama, you've met Rose Alvarez from the office.
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez? I can't believe it. Rose, what happened? You've had a sudden shock or something? Excuse me, Albert. I think I'll go see if Conrad's here. By all means, Miss Alvarez. Look at her, Sonny. How nice she looks. It's a wonder to me some older man doesn't snatch her up. A personal matron like that with brains and a few dollars. What a catch you'd be for a convalescent. Goodbye, Rose. Goodbye, May.
The luggage? Oh, I'm sorry, Rosie. It's on your way.
And call me Mrs. Peterson.
Mama, what I wanted to talk to you about was sort of about Rose. Maybe you'd better sit down.
Why? I know my sonny. He loves his mama. He wouldn't do anything to break her heart. Go ahead, dear. What about Rose?
Well, it's about Lou, too.
Lou! Where are you, Lou? Struck down by a beverage I consumed faithfully for 32 years? What about Lou?
Well, it's just that Rose thinks, and I agree, that I should dissolve Almy Lou. Mom, are you okay?
It's nothing. You killed me, that's all. Lou, I'm coming. I'm on my way up.
Mama, you don't understand. It's just that Rose thought. I thought. Here, let me help you get up. Here's some money. Take the taxi home. Subways are too crowded.
Nothing is too crowded for a mother. I'll take the IRT. That's the worst subway. Wait a moment. How many blocks is it after all? Only 107. A rock.
Mama.
Enjoy yourself, son. Take care. Wear your heavy coat. Be careful crossing the street. Keep your money in your inside pocket. Wear your galoshes and eat a hot lunch. Gently.
Well, I was going to. It was just that she was so upset about my leaving that I thought I'd better wait.
You mean you didn't?
He's coming! He's coming! Conrad, hurry! He's coming!
Hey, Conrad, how about answering a few questions? How do you feel about joining the army? How does he feel? You ask how he feels. He's much too shy to tell you, so I'll tell you how he feels. He feels brave and eager. strangely humble, proud to be a plain GI.
He will gladly face those bullets.
On a Hollywood starlet, Conrad. Are you two engaged?
Is he engaged? Is Conrad engaged? There's absolutely nothing to the rumor he's engaged.
She's a real pal, like a sister, but doesn't mean a thing. And that 18-carat diamond, it was just a friendship ring.
For he's a
sing.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad. We'll meet you.
Oh, I'll never forget Conrad's first words when he found out he got accepted into the armed forces. Say, Mr. Peterson, he cried eagerly. Do you think I'll be assigned into the frontline trenches? Then I'll get myself one of them dirty Jerrys.
Albert!
Or whoever's dirty this time.
Hey, Mr. Peterson, give us the real scoop. Is Conrad still drinking a lot?
He
doesn't touch a drop.
He's as decent as a minister.
Absolutely.
He's as sober as a judge. He subscribes to every charity. And his hobby's making fudge.
But he's a
Southern
charm. Soon he drifted down to
every evening by the river,
to the waterfront zone,
by the moonlight they would croon.
That is where I heard him sing.
That's where Conrad started singing.
Eat that dirty hole.
Eat that sweet plantation moon.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. I love you, Conrad.
He's a
Why, Hugo, I believe you're actually jealous of Conrad! please. I'm the opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous. And I have every right to be. Kim is my city.
That's just right, Hugo. I'm your city. Oh, I might admire Conrad Birdie as one does a far distant and unattainable ideal. But you're my city, no matter how common, ordinary you are. That's how it's going to stay.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better?
Every word of it, Hugo. Conrad Birdie's just a fling. This city is forever.
Stop! I can't finish
against my speech.
Who cares about your speech? We want to hear from Conrad. Speak to us, O beautiful one. Tell us how you make that glorious sound that even now, in anticipation of, has been reduced to a snarling, raging, panting, jungle beast.
You've got to be sincere.
Now, what's the matter?
You got me sincere.
Mr. Penny, what are you doing?
You gotta feel it here. Cause if you feel it here, well, then it's gonna be honestly sincere. If what you feel is true, really feel it you, make them feel it too. Write this down now, you gotta be sincere, honestly sincere. Man, you gotta be sincere. If you're really sincere, if you're really sincere, if you feel it in here, then it's gotta be right, baby.
Look, I know the town special breakfast for Mr. Birdie. And I want to make sure everything is ready and waiting for him by the time he gets down here. After all, he is a national figure. And I want to show those New York people that we know how to treat a national figure here in Sweet Apple. Of course, it doesn't matter to me much personally, but for kids, that guy. Oh, there you go. All done, dear. Did you enjoy it? Good. Now, if you'll just hurry along.
Doris, I am not budging from this table till I get my coffee, smoke a cigarette, and read my paper.
I'm sorry, dear. I didn't have time to make your coffee this morning. How about a nice, warm 7-Up?
Good morning, Pop. Piece of paper. Hope you don't mind when I cut a few articles out about Conrad.
I have tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I have extended the privilege of self-determination to both the women I have married and the children I have sired. The vote has been denied no one for reason of age, sex, or political affiliation. There has been no taxation without representation, and open covenants have been openly arrived at. Last night, I gave in my room to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as fat. Telephone calls were made to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong. I slept on a camp cot with my feet in the fireplace and my head in an ashtray. Outside my window, three harpies shrieked, "We love you, Conrad!" 4,723 times! I have just lost two fried eggs! Gentlemen, the democracy is over. Parliament has been dissolved, the Magna Carta is revoked, and Nero is back in town. And you don't offer an emperor a warm 7-Up?
Oh, Mr. McAfee, I hope you don't mind staying on the phone for a few minutes. I'm expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Perfectly all right. I'll go out and burn Rome.
Mother, what's wrong?
Nothing. Dear, your father's just excited about Conrad's being here, that's all.
He's coming! He's coming! Mother, you give the candy dog and the eggs!
Girls, he's coming. You better hurry if you want to watch him eat.
Here we are, Kim.
I'm sorry, Doris. We just had to come. We'll stand quietly back there.
He's here!
This Sunday night at 8:05, and you're all going to be on. That's why I beg you to put aside all petty differences. For that great audience out there, you're an American dream come true. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't destroy that
Drink.
He on the Ed Sullivan Show? Ed Sullivan. Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with Ed Sullivan.
Has made me see things in a different light, and I wanted to let you know that I wrote Mama and told her that no matter what, I'm going to dissolve Alloy Lou.
Oh, Albert, you didn't!
But I did. I wrote her the night we left, which leaves her 3 days and three nights, and so far not a word. If you ask me, she's accepted the whole thing by now.
3 days, three nights on a trailways bus. But what's the difference? I'm only a mother, and for a mother, a trailways bus is good enough.
Mama, what are you doing here?
Did you think I would come? A mother gets a letter, obviously written under the influence of drugs, and she should stay at home? No attention, it's only a mother's tears. Dear Mom, this is to let you know that Alma Lou is dissolved. Your friend Albert. Alma Lou is dissolved! Dissolved me! But who am I, anyways? A sick, old woman who probably won't last the night. I just want a simple stone with one word carved on it. Albert's mother. And don't hire a limousine to get me to the final resting place. I'll walk.
Mama.
And tell that skinny friend of yours I forgive her. She knoweth not what she done it.
Mama, Rose is right here.
This is Rose? I can't believe it. She looks like she just escaped from Rutgers Island. For her own sake, Sonny, send her back to the Midwest. And don't worry about a secretary. It so happens I met on the bus a perfect secretary, a wonderful, refined girl on her way to Akron, only I persuaded her to get off here. Sonny, say hello to Gloria Rasputin.
Hi, Al.
Hey, you're cute.
But Mom, I don't need a secretary. I have Rosie.
What is
Rosie need a job for. In a year or two, she'll be getting Social Security.
Well, listen, I don't just type.
You do other things?
I tap dance. I figured I could help you with the secretary stuff, and you would help me get into show business. Hold this, honey. Meg, can you hum Swanee River?
It's my favorite selection.
Get a load of this, Al.
Da 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 da.
Well, I mean, you certainly do have wonderful qualifications, but I'm used to working with Miss Alvarez here, and... Well, it's as you say, Mama, we do have all this extra work, and... Do you have to stay down there?
For a few minutes. May, give me a hand, will you? Al, you push from the other side.
Sonny, for the movies, they can always cut away while they jack her up. Now, why don't you take Gloria somewhere and see how fast she types?
Well... We do have all these extra releases to get out, and Gloria could do them. Unless it makes any difference to you, Rosie.
Why should it make any difference to me, Albert?
Atta girl, Rosie.
I'll find you a typewriter.
Do you use the touch system?
Whenever possible.
I could kill him. Oh, I could just kill him!
Miss Alvarez, no one came in and didn't tell her that she's not to kiss Comrade Birdie on that Sullivan show tonight. Because if she does, then no! Miss Alvarez? Hello, Miss Alvarez? Anybody home? Is there anything I can do for you, Miss Alvarez?
Yes, Hugo. I think you can.
So remember, your surest way to the best in color slides is to insist on the new Kodak. And now, the young man you've all been waiting to see. As you know, in just about 14 hours, one of show business's brightest talents is going off to play a very special engagement. And tonight, before he goes, he wants to leave a certain lucky young lady with one last kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, we take you to Sweet Apple, Ohio, where a typical American family, Mr. and Mrs. Harry McAfee, and their children, Randolph and Kim, are gathered to bid farewell to a typical American soldier, Conrad Birdie!
Where's that?
Oh, one last kiss. Oh, give me one last kiss. It never felt like this. No, maybe not like this. You know I need your love. So give me one last kiss. Oh, one more time. Oh, baby, one more time. It really is sublime. Oh, honey, so sublime. You know I need your love. So give me one last kiss.
Brace yourself, Conrad Birdie!
Hugo! You hit him!
He deserved it! He was a thief of love!
Hugo Peabody, I never want to see you again!
I demand to know who's responsible for this! Who let that kid in here?
I did, Albert!
Rosie!
It was just a parting gift to you, Mrs. Crosbuten. Where did you go?
But Rosie, you can't just leave me here all alone!
You're not alone, Albert! You're on television!
For he's a fine, upstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy.
For he's a
guilt for being in love with a mama, clutching aspirin, splitting Tyson's tower of jello. What did I ever see in him? How did I ever get involved that way? Now that it's over, I can smile and say, what did I ever see in him? Boy, I was way out on a limb. Now that I'm safely on the ground again, now that my senses have been found.
You've just suffered a severe shock, and the best thing right now is to get upstairs and... Aha! There she is! The woman that stabbed me in the heart while my back was turned!
Get out of my way, Albert! Be careful, Sonny. She may be armed.
I can handle her, Mama. You go upstairs and see that Conrad gets into bed.
Wait for me, Conrad. I'll make you a nice hot cup of tyramycin.
For the last time, will you get out of my way? I'm going on the town tonight, and another minute.
Not until I've had my say, Rose. Thanks to Mama's quick thinking, the kiss will still take place after all. Tomorrow morning at the railroad station, just before Conrad leaves. So it looks like you failed, Rose. Has anyone messed with fail who tries to buck out Peterson? What are the titans? What are the giants? What are the King Kongs of the music industry?
What did I ever see in him? How could I ever think that he was nice? Take it from me, I paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken heart.
An empire builder, a colossus.
Get out of my way, you defrauded English teacher.
What did I ever see in him?
Please come back. Do you hear me? This is King Kong calling. Rosie, please, I need you. Rosie, please. Rosie, I don't care how much you plead and beg, Miss Alvarez. You're through here, Delmay-Lew. Not only do I accept your resignation, but you're also fired. And I want you to remember one more thing. Sticks and stones will break my bones, but names will never harm me, you big brat. Sorry to do this to you folks, but I've had to let Miss Alvarez go. I'll get that.
Probably Hong Kong again.
Hello, this is Albert Peterson. Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Lewis. Miss Alvarez is no longer with us. That's right.
Miss Alvarez, wait for me!
And where do you think you're going, young lady?
With Rosie, to drink deep the dregs and sip foolhardy the brimming cup. To live.
Upstairs!
Dad!
Upstairs! Do you hear me? I said upstairs!
Miss Alvarez was right! You're all the same from puberty to Mussolini!
What's that? You dare to say puberty in front of your own father? Not to mention Mussolini!
Doris, we failed as parents.
I never ask much from my children. Just respect. A little respect. That's all I ask for. Respect. But did I get respect? I did not get respect. I got no respect.
Well, I respect you, Pa.
I don't want your respect. You're a child. What good is respect from a child?
Doris, take me upstairs. I'm not a well man.
Certain words I don't want to hear in this house. Puberty was the first, and Mussolini was the second, and respect was the third.
Now listen here, Mr. Lewis. No 3-cent reporter can bulldoze me. I happen to be Albert J. Peterson, and you can print that name in whatever cheap paper you happen to represent.
It's not a paper. It's a magazine. And it's not Mr. Lewis. It's Mr. Luce. As in Time Magazine, Mr. Luce? Oh, Rosie, please, I need you!
Sonny boy, where are you going?
Nowhere's, Mama. Just out. It's stuffy in here, so I thought, to look for Rosie, Mama. I love her, and I want her back.
Is that all? I thought it was something serious. By all means, Sonny, find your Lady of Allentown and bring her back here. Oh, and by the way, dear, when you get back, be sure to stop in the kitchen, take my head out of the oven, and turn off the gas.
Mama.
It's a strange house. I don't want to run up a bill.
Mama, I've had enough of this. If you really love me, you'd help me find Rosie before it's too late. Don't you understand what's just happened? That poor girl's gone out to make up for all the years that she's wasted on me. Who knows what low dive she's in this very moment?
Oh, Sonny, you're right. I'll help you find her. Only, maybe I better give you the message from Conrad first.
What message?
Oh, nothing to worry about, darling. It's just, he just says he's going out tonight and he doesn't think he'll be back on time to kiss Kim tomorrow.
Mama, why didn't you tell me this before?
Well, I tried to, darling, sweetheart, but you kept bringing up a certain Midwestern hussy.
I don't know what the matter with him is. He knows how much this means to me. Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy, I'm coming. And before you start hollering, Albert, I just want you to know I've made up my mind. I'm tired of getting up at 9 every morning, having people watch me when I eat, and letting kids poke me in the eye. I want to go out, have some fun, meet a couple of the other chicks. Don't you understand, Albert? I am tense!
Mama, don't just stand there, do something!
Conrad, did you ever think in terms of a more mature woman?
Well, I hope I don't get that tense. Now listen here, my boy. This is my last free night before I go into the army, and I am going out!
You can't go out without my permission. It says so in your contract. Mama, get my contract. It's in my... Oh, never mind. I'll get it myself. Conrad, you stay right here!
Conrad!
Our cheeks just right for some kissing. And I need to kiss me up you. Already for tasting, and there's Cadillacs all shiny and new. Got a moon There's such a lot of living to do.
Alone.
Hey, ain't you the chick I was supposed to kiss?
I am not a chick. As a matter of fact, I am a fully grown woman, and I insist on being treated as such. In fact, that's why I ran away from home.
Hey, you like a chick? Come on, we got things to do. Crazy clothes and motorboat races.
I wonder where I can buy BBs this late at night. that hurts.
Kids!
Why don't they lower the draft age to about 11?
Kids!
I didn't know what puberty was until I was almost past it. Laughing.
Can you make me a vodka malted?
How old are you?
32.
Get out. What about a beer?
Yeah.
Just let me sit here with an empty glass in front of me.
Ow!
Where's the manager? I demand to see Maul.
I'm Maul. Charles F. Maul. And if you're not out of here in the next minute, I'll take you by the scruff of the neck and throw you out.
Okay, okay, I'm going. Last time you were drinking here.
Double bourbon, scotch on the side, and put a cherry in it. Make that two cherries and bring on the dancing boys.
Get out.
No, wait a minute. You can't do that. I'm an American
Hello?
Citizen.
Hi, this is Albert Peterson. I'm calling to see if Rose Alvarez is there.
It's all sorts of wild and treacherous.
Rose Alvarez. In fact, I think I can hear her speak right now.
Party.
Could
when
you put her on the phone, please?
Coming out. I mean, coming out.
Hey, lady, there's a guy named Peterson on the phone for you.
Tell that weasley little rat I'm not here.
Well, that proves she's there. Who else would know that I'm a weasley little rat? Rosie, I need to talk to you about Conrad. Conrad?
And furthermore, even if I were Miss Rose, which I'm not, the only thing that would make me hang up is the mention of anybody named Conrad.
Oh, Rosie, please don't hang up. We'll talk about anything. You, me, I, anything. Oh, Rosie, please.
Talk to me, baby, won't you? Talk to me. I don't care what you say. Baby, talk to me. Must you be so far away from me? It seems all wrong this way. Talk to me. If you miss me, tell me so. Are you lonely? Tell me so. Say you love me. Tell me so, honey. Let me know. Talk to me till I press you close to me.
Parties, dancers, balls?
yours, Lane. That's a private dining room.
Private? For who?
For men only, that's for who.
Men only? That's exactly what I'm looking for. I've heard about what goes on in these small towns. I'm Rosie's wife!
Hey, somebody, hey, Simon! Wait, Rosie! I'm on my way back! Mama! Get my coat!
It's so, fellow Shriners, with the power vested in me. Now, before the recording secretary reads the minutes of last week's meeting, I'd like to mention something that I'm sure is on everybody's mind tonight.
Mrs. Arbus, could you do me a favor? Could you go back in there and give me some grain alcohol to go?
Not for $1 million!
But my whole world's collapsing for me. I can get a drink, and Kim and Conrad have gone onto the ice house.
Kim and Conrad? Albert, I've gotta go find Albert!
There it is! Mom's outside the tree. I'm coming, Rosie! Hurry, Mama.
I don't know why we have to go running around all night looking for someone it would be better not to find. You ask me, Sonny, you'll come home, have a nice hot cup of cocoa, and go to bed.
I'm not coming home until I find Rosie. Now, if you want to go, that's okay with me. In fact, that's not a bad idea, Mama. Why don't you go home?
Would you mind repeating that, sweetheart darling?
I said, why don't you go home, Mama?
One more time, sunshine of my existence?
I said, why don't you go home, Mama? I don't need you anymore.
So, it's come at last. At last, it's come. The day I knew it would come at last has come at last. My sunny boy doesn't need me any longer. Well, what are you waiting for? Get rid of me. Put me out with the garbage. Just throw me out with the used grapefruits, the empty cans with tuna fish. Never mind putting a lid on it. Leave it open so 100,000 pussycats walk all over Mother. Who bronzed your baby shoes? Kissed every little bruise. Picked your dirty socks up. Now a mother doesn't matter.
A mother is lined up the sanitation truck, bound for the city dump. Her son is running around with a floozy looking for a good time. Stay true to an American woman's life. Who gave up nights of rest to rub bits on his chest.
Mama.
Yes, sonny boy.
Good night, Mama.
You know, you're just like your father. You would marry anything. Good night, sonny boy.
My name is not Sonny Boy.
Good night, Albert!
Mr. Peterson! Have you seen Conrad and Kim?
Ah, pleasure, Mr. McAfee. Unfortunately, I have a study that Conrad's affair is no longer interesting, and I'm trying to find Rosie to tell her that...
Conrad and Kim?
They've run off together!
And if we don't find them soon, Mr. Peterson, I intend to call the FBI! Who's the head of it now, dear? Is it Peter Lawford yet?
Sure, there's nothing to worry about.
Doris, Harry, have you seen Ursula?
Ursula.
Is she missing too?
Yes, since then, I looked everywhere.
Mr. Peterson! You haven't seen my harbinger, have you?
Roger and Phyllis.
They're all probably at the drugstore, doing one of those game wars.
Ursula, Deborah Sue, the Girl Scouts.
Conrad, you seem a bit anxious. Conrad, wait. I don't know, it can be a little awkward because I'm a little older than you. I'm 27 or 28, one of those two. So, you know, I really know the score. I even know some of those words, you know, like premarital, connubial, jovate.
There you are, oh sensuous one. We've been looking for you everywhere.
Oh, that's nice. Now, out of my way. I'm late.
You don't understand. We're coming with you.
No, wait a minute.
You said it yourself. We've got all the flipping to do.
Moonlight swims.
Motorboat races.
Loop-de-loops.
Yeah!
Of course, that stuff really ain't as much fun as I made out.
Ooh, I know. We can have an orgy.
What's going on here? Conrad? Conrad! There he is! The depraved brute! Arrest that man! Well now, what have you got to say, Mr. Birdie?
Just say I'm the cook!
Everybody, good old Hugo again.
Oh, Hugo, darling, thank God you're here. You have no idea what embarrassment I've been made to suffer.
That's all I need to hear. Take him away!
Hey, wait a minute, Mr. McAfee. I demand you to release that boy. Do you hear me? This is Albert Peterson speaking. Mr. McAfee!
Albert, it's no use. Look, why don't you go back to the house and gather our things? I'll go down to the courthouse and try to talk to the mayor.
I guess you didn't understand before when I said I was a new man, Rosie.
But Albert...
No, but Albert me, Rose. You are merely a woman. I am man. A woman's job is to obey and keep the house clean and speak only when she speaks to me. And my first command, woman, is for you to get her luggage and bring her to the station by 6:30, where I intend to meet her with Conrad. And furthermore, I command you to bring whatever legal documents are necessary, for I intend to make you Miss Albert Peterson by 2400 hours tomorrow. Roger, over and out.
Oh, Rosie, did I mention that I love you?
Not yet, Albert.
Well, I do.
Conrad!
Oh, Rosie, nothing can stop you now. Hello, Rose.
Hello, May.
Finally, alone at last. Don't you have a moment to spare for a heart-to-heart with an old friend?
I'll always have a moment for the woman who, by tomorrow evening, I'll be able to call...
Don't say it, Rose.
I'll be able to call Mother.
The cruelest word I've ever heard. To think... I'd live to see the day I'd have relatives in Pennsylvania.
Not to mention Ohio, Wisconsin, Illinois, and Brooklyn! When Albert and I are married...
Not Brooklyn.
Anything but Brooklyn. Yes, Meg, Brooklyn! When Albert and I are married, he will be a Brooklynite, and yous can come and visit. See you later, May.
Oh, forget about it, Rosie.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
It's gonna be such a wonderful life. I'm going to be Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs.
Goodbye, dear. And don't worry about the fur. You'll have three mixed those as soon as the train passes over me.
I am sick and tired of all of your nonsense. Now get up and get on that train.
Just a moment, Mr. Peterson! I demand to know what you've done with Mr. Birdie! He's not in that jail!
How should I know? I haven't seen him all night, and I've come here to find Rosie.
Mr. Peterson!
There's no point in getting all excited, dear. After all, there's no real harm done. Kim and Hugo are back together again. As a matter of fact, the sweetest thing happened. He proposed to her this morning, she accepted him. Dear, what's wrong?
My life is now over. I'll sell the house and go back to a home.
On the board.
Albert, get out of the train, please.
Bye, Conrad. Pumpkin Falls, Iowa.
What's in Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
An opening in the teaching staff at Pumpkin Falls Junior High. I read it in the morning's paper. They're looking for a domestic science teacher and an English teacher. And they prefer the applicants to be married.
Oh, Albert!
Oh, Rosie, did I mention that it's the most beautiful name in the world?
I was never crazy for flowers. I confess that nothing left me older. I could watch a daisy for hours, and all I'd feel is several hours older. Lilacs or lilies, any bloom you please, all that they did was make me shrug or sneeze. But now I love each blossom that I see. Rosie, with a girl like Rosie, how can I be blue? Head in head will mosey, me and little Rosie, we could be so cozy by a fire built for two. Oh, I once heard a poem that goes, a rose is a rose is a rose. Well, I don't agree, take it from me. There's one rose sweeter than any that grows, and that's my Rosie. I'm so glad she shows me life is one sweet, beautiful song to me.
Sweet.